How long is this Uber and Lyft driver shortage actually going to last? That's what we're talking about right now. Hey everyone, my name is Chris and this is Real Rideshare Stories. And today we're going to talk about how long is the Uber and Lyft driver shortage actually going to last? Is this going to be something that could be solved very quickly, or is it going to take something in order to get more drivers on the road? So the other day I did put out a poll on the community tab asking how long you think that it was going to last. And we're going to go over that right now. And also, just to put this out there, this is pure speculation. We don't really know how long this driver shortage actually is going to last, but there could be some key points when drivers will come back on the road, if they do at all. So now let's go to the poll and see exactly what your thoughts are and when you think that this driver shortage actually will end. So going to the poll, it says, how long do you think Uber and Lyft driver shortage will last? Now, most people who responded to this poll think that it's going to end once pandemic unemployment assistance ends. And I have to agree with that. If I answered this poll, that would be my option as well too. Although it could take a little bit longer because I think that a lot of drivers who were driving for Uber and Lyft have gone on to other ventures, whether that's a different job, whether that's a different part of the gig economy, like food delivery or package courier or anything like that, then I think it's going to be harder for people to come back to the platform because maybe they don't like it anymore. Maybe they don't want to deal with people, the problems and the issues that come with being an Uber or Lyft driver. They might have that out of their rearview mirror. Now, also, going on, they say some people think it's going to end through the summer. Other people say through the rest of the year. But 24% say they don't care anymore because they're done with them. They're not going to be doing it any longer. And that could be a big reason why this driver shortage is happening in the first place. 25% is quite a bit. Now, I know a lot of people are on unemployment and not worrying about going out taking rides, or they fear that they're going to get sick or anything like that. They don't want to pass it around. Whatever it might be, they're not back on the road for that particular reason. Not only that, you're getting $300 plus 50% of the state average every single week. What Uber and Lyft are offering is nothing comparative. Oh, you can do three rides and get an extra $100? Well, that's not really a lot. And then going on where it says the comments, a couple of people were saying once rates actually go up. But either way, you're probably going to see this driver shortage go through however long pandemic unemployment assistance is going to last. Right now, it's through September. And if they extend it further, then this driver shortage will last longer. But if the PUA ends at that time frame, you're probably going to see more drivers coming on the road in the fall time. Now, Uber and Lyft might be scrambling at this point to try to bring on drivers or new drivers. But what about the drivers that are on the road since the whole time? They're not really doing anything there except for maybe offering surge because it's busier. Now, that is true, but the problem is they're not getting anything extra. They've been driving either the whole time or even a good chunk of the time during this whole pandemic, but yet Uber and Lyft aren't recognizing that or aren't giving them anything extra. They're making it seem like they're doing more for them, even though they're not. It's just supply and demand. That's what comes down to surge in these power zones. Now, I'm always a proponent of saying that the mileage rate and the time rate should actually be higher. Reason is because it's only slightly over the IRS deductible. So if you actually average out all of your expenses, all of your ratios, all of that good stuff, you're probably not making as much as you think you are. And also, you're really trading the depreciation of your car into cash on hand. Now, you could have some strategies out there that are actually giving you a little bit more money. And because there's less drivers on the road and a higher demand for rides, probably making some pretty good money, especially if you're driving Uber and seeing a lot of surge in your particular market. Now, all good things will come to an end, including this driver shortage, because all the drivers out there right now are making more money. But it should come down to higher pay rates nonetheless, because gas is going up. That's a big expense when it comes to Uber and Lyft driving because you're driving people all over the place. So as gas goes up, rates should be going up, not staying the same or even decreasing in some markets like they are. But we'll fast forward in a few months' time and see. Will that be the big turnaround point when the PUA ends or not? Or will Uber and Lyft try to employ some other tactic to try to bring drivers back on the road or keep current drivers happy? Because that might anger a lot of drivers out there, and they might just be part of the other 24% that said they're done with Uber or Lyft. Now, what are your thoughts on this? Do you think that this driver shortage will last until the PUA ends? Do you think it's going to be something different? Or are you done with Uber and Lyft? Comment below, let me know. All right, that's the end of the video. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring the bell for notifications so you'll be notified every time a new video is uploaded. And as always, never drink and drive. Always tip your drivers, deliver drivers, and your shoppers. And we'll see you next time.